So hello students, a warm welcome to MRS math class. One comment has come in the last video that whether I am teaching physics. No, I am actually teaching mathematics and this fluid dynamics is a branch of applied mathematics and in which we are using some physics concept. Okay, that's why this topic is more interesting. Okay. So, whatever the last class we have discussed about the basic concepts of fluid dynamics, right? But in this class, I will derive Euler's equation of motion, okay? So, whatever we discussed in the last class, that is Euler's equation of motion is the sum of force due to gravitation and force due to pressure, right? That is F is equal to Fg plus Fp, right? This is force due to gravitation and this is force due to pressure. So let us calculate this one by assuming a streamline flow S, okay, and a cylindrical element, this small cylindrical element, okay, and the cross section area is dA, okay, and the length of this element is dS, okay. So we will calculate what are the forces acting on this element, okay. First of all, you can see that this point, you can take this point as A and this point as B. At this point, the pressure existing in this direction, okay, along the streamline, okay. Then what will be the force acting at this point? That will be your P into dA, that is area of cross section, okay. But if we'll move small distance, that is dS, then what will be the pressure at this point? We know that if we are moving a small distance and whatever the other parameters changing for this reason, we can calculate according to the Taylor's equation, right? So at this point, that is P at S plus dS will be our P plus dou P by dou S into dS. Right. So what will be the force at this point, which is equal to P plus dou P by dou S into dS into dA, right, which is in the normal direction of the surface and towards the element, right? Now if we'll consider the rho as the fluid density, then what will be the weight existing, right? This weight will be vertically downwards, that is if we will consider W, then it will be the product of fluid density, that is rho, right, in the volume of the element, that is dA into dS, right, into gravitational acceleration, right, that is g, okay, this is the force existing here. And if we'll take this weight inclined at an angle theta, okay, from this streamline, okay, then this weight will resolve in two components, okay. If we'll consider the horizontal component, then what will be the component? That will be rho dA dS g into cos theta, right? So draw a reference line in x axis, okay, and dz is a small elevation of point B, okay, with respect to A. Okay. Then what will be your cos theta in this case? Cos theta will be dz by ds, right? So we can replace cos theta as dz by ds. Now we calculated all the forces that are acting on this element. Okay, so the net force will be equal to, according to the Newton's second law, if you are considering force for streamline, that will be Fs is equal to mass into acceleration along streamline, that is As. Okay, that is Newton's second law, right? So this Fs is the resultant force acting on this element, right? So what will be our Fs in this case? That is PdA minus this force, right? That is P plus del P by del S into ds into dA, right? Minus this, right? Rho dA ds g cos theta, right? Which is equal to your mass. What is mass here? That is rho into dA ds, right? And what will be acceleration? So then, since this velocity is a function of s and t, right? So whenever you are calculating as, we have to derive dv by dt, right? That is del v over del s into ds by dt, right? Plus del v by del t, right? So what is ds by dt? That is your again v into del v by del s plus del v by del t, correct? So as this del v by del t is our local acceleration, and this one is your convective acceleration, right? So we can apply here into as, that is v by del s. Okay. And this del v by del t will be equal to 0, because the flow we are considered here, that is steady flow. That means velocity will not change when time varies. Okay, so del v by del t we are taking, considering 0. So only v del v by del s. Okay. Now our Euler's equation we can get by solving this equation, right? So to solve this differential equation, okay, we will divide this equation by rho dA ds. Okay. Then here you can see, we can strike this term PdA and PdA. Okay. And what you will get? That is minus del P by del S, right? Into ds dA, it will cancel, right? Because we are dividing the whole term by rho dA ds. Okay, so here it will be one rho will be there, and this dA ds dA it will cancel, right? So minus rho will cancel, ds dA it will cancel, only g cos theta, right? Again, this one if you take to left hand side, what you will get? Minus road VADS it will cancel, only V del V over del S equal to 0, right? Now from each term we will take negative sign common, okay? Then what we will get? This is del P by del S into rho plus G, and cos theta is our dz by ds, right? So dz by ds minus, this will be plus, right? V by del S equal to 0, okay? So this partial differential equation we can convert to exact differential equation, because all the terms are depending on S, and everything is along the streamline, right? So this one we can write dP by rho ds, right, plus g dz by ds plus v dv by ds equal to 0, right? Now we can take common 1 by ds, right? So what will happen? If you take 1 by ds common, then here it will be dp by rho plus g dz plus v dv equal to 0, right? And since 1 by ds cannot be 0, the final equation you will get, that is dp over rho plus g dz plus v dv equal to 0. So this one is our Euler's equation of motion. So now we will discuss on some assumptions, whatever we have considered throughout the derivation. Okay. First of all, you can see there exist 5 types of force in a flow, but here we have neglected rest 3 forces, right? So first point is flow is inviscid. Okay, that means inviscid fluid. Okay, first one is inviscid. Okay, and second one is we have neglected force due to compressibility. Okay, that means it is a incompressible fluid. Okay, okay. You can see that since the fluid is inviscid and incompressible, okay, so we can say that fluid is, what is, last class I have already discussed the definition of ideal fluid and real fluid. So ideal fluid is incompressible and inviscid. So we can say that this Euler's equation of motion is valid for ideal fluid, okay? And the third one is we have considered the steady flow, right? That's why our del V by del T is 0, okay? So these 3 assumptions we have considered for Euler's equation of motion, okay? So hope you understood whatever I explained. So in the next video I will derive Bernoulli equation with the help of Euler's equation of motion. Okay students, thank you so much for your patience. If you want to give any suggestions, please write in the comment box.